So what is syntax law? 1 by 4 square plus x square is into dx is equal to 1 by 4 tan inverse of x by 4. What is a? A is equal to 4 here. So applying the value here, so a by pi 1 by 4 tan inverse of x by 4. Limit is minus infinity to plus infinity, that is equal to 1. So a by 4 pi tan inverse of upper limit is plus infinity minus tan inverse of lower limit is minus infinity, that is equal to 1. So minus to minus becomes plus, therefore tan inverse of infinity plus tan inverse of infinity. So when you add these two values, you get 2 times tan inverse of infinity. Therefore a by 4 pi into 2 times tan inverse of infinity, that is equal to 1. Therefore what is tan inverse of infinity is, that is pi by 2. So when you cancel this 2 as well as pi, therefore a by 4 is equal to what? 1. So what is the value of a? That is 4. So what is the option is? C is the correct option, that is 4. Question number 127. A random variable capital X has the following probability distribution. So given by the table X 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The probability of X is 1 by 4, 2A, 3A, 4A, 5A, 1 by 4. Then probability of 1 less than or equal to X less than or equal to 4 is option A 10 by 21, option B 2 by 7, option C is 1 by 14, option D 1 by 2. So we know that for a discrete random variable, the total probability value becomes what? 1. So when you add all these values, so you get 1. Therefore 1 by 4 plus 2A plus 3A plus 4A plus 5A plus 1 by 4, that is equal to 1. So when you add 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4, you get 1 by 2. When you add all the A values here, so you get 14A. So 14A is equal to 1 minus 1 by 2. So what is 1 minus 1 by 2 is 1 by 2. So therefore the value of A is 1 by 28. Now you have to calculate the probability value in between 1 and 4. Therefore what are the values of X is equal to 1 to X is equal to 4 is 2A, 3A, 4A, 5A. The total value is 14A. What is A value is 1 by 28. When you cancel with the 2, we will get 1 by 2. So D is the correct option, that is 1 by 2. 128. A random variable capital X has the following probability mass function as follows. Capital X minus 2, 3, 1. Probability of X is equal to small x, lambda by 6, lambda by 4, lambda by 12. Then the value of lambda is option A 1, option B 2, option C 3, option D 4. Since the given probability mass function, we know that sigma pa is equal to 1. So this is a property. Therefore when you add all the probability value, it becomes 1. Therefore lambda by 6 plus lambda by 4 plus lambda by 12 is equal to 1. So when you take 12 as the LCM, so 2 lambda plus 3 lambda plus lambda is equal to 1. So what is the total value? This is 6 lambda. So 6 lambda by 12 is equal to 1. So when you cancel with the 2, we will get lambda by 2 is equal to 1. So what is lambda? Lambda is equal to 2. Therefore B is the correct option, that is 2. Question number 129. X is a discrete random variable which takes the value 0, 1, 2 and P of capital X is equal to 0 is equal to 144 by 169. P of capital X is equal to 1, 1 by 169. Then the value of P of X is equal to 2 is option A 145 by 169, option B 24 by 169, option C 2 by 169, option D 143 by 169. So since it is a probability mass function, therefore sigma pa is equal to 1. Since x is a discrete, therefore sigma pa is equal to 1. So there are three values are given, that is probability of x is equal to 0 plus probability of x is equal to 1 plus probability of x is equal to 2. The total value becomes 1. Only three x values are given. Therefore what is the probability of p of x equal to 0 is 144 by 169, p of x equal to 1 is equal to 1 by 169 plus p of x is equal to 2 is equal to 1. So when you add these two values, we will get 145 by 169. Therefore, P of x equal to 2 is equal to 1 minus 145 by 169. So when you take the LCM, we get 169 minus 145 by 169. So when you subtract 169 minus 145, you get 24, 24 by 169. So what is P of x equal to 2? 24 by 169. So B is the correct option, that is 24 by 169. Question number 130. A random variable capital X has the following probability distribution function given by this table. Then the value of K is option A 1 by 8, option B 1 by 10, option C 0, option D minus 1 or 1 by 10. Since X is a discrete random variable, which means that sigma pi is equal to 1, the total probability value becomes 1. So when you add all the probability values here, that is 0 plus k plus 2k plus 2k plus 3k plus k square plus 2k square plus 7k square plus k, that is equal to 1. So the total value of k is 9k. Then when you add the k square value, you get 10k square, that is equal to 1. So 10k square minus 9k minus 1 is equal to 0. So when you factorize this, we get 10k minus 1 into k plus 1 is equal to 0. Therefore, k is equal to 1 by 10 or k is equal to minus 1. So here, k cannot be a negative value. Therefore, k must be a positive value. Therefore, k is equal to 1 by 10. So what is the option here? B is the correct option, that is 1 by 10. Question number 131. Given E of x plus c is equal to 8 and E of x minus c is equal to 12, then the value of c is option A minus 2, option B 4, option C minus 4, option D 2. Since expectation of any constant is a constant, here c is a constant, when you take the expectation of any constant is a constant, so you have to apply the rule here. E of x plus c, that is equal to 8, that means E of x plus E of c, that is equal to 8. So what is expectation of constant is constant. Therefore, E of x plus c equal to 8. So you can call it as equation number 1. Now we move to other equation, that is E of x minus c is equal to 12. Therefore, E of x minus E of c, that is equal to 12. So here is also expectation of constant is a constant. Therefore, E of x minus c is equal to 12. So you can call it as equation number 2. So subtracting equation number 1 with the 2, which implies that E of x plus c is equal to 8, E of x minus c is equal to 12. So when you subtract this, so E of x will be get cancelled. So c plus c becomes 2c, that is equal to minus 4. What is c? C is equal to minus 2. So what is option here? A is the correct option, that is c is equal to minus 2. Question number 132. X is a random variable taking the values 3, 4 and 12 with the corresponding probabilities 1 by 3, 1 by 4 and 5 by 12. Then E of X is option A 5, option B 7, option C 6, option D 3. So here only the 3 values are given and 3 probabilities are given. Then what is the expectation of the random variable capital X is X1 P1 plus X2 P2 plus X3 P3. So we have to multiply the X values with the corresponding probabilities. Therefore, 3 into 1 by 3 plus 4 into 1 by 4 plus 12 into 5 by 12. So here 3 will be get cancelled, 4 will be get cancelled, 12 will be get cancelled. So what is the remaining value is 1 plus 1 plus 5. Therefore, the total value is 7. So what is E of X is 7. So here the option is B, that is 7/133. Variance of the random variable capital X is 4. Mean is 2, then E of X prime is option A 2, option B 4, option C 6, option D 8. So what is the variance of X? Variance of X is given by the formula E of X square minus E of X the whole square. Here mean means E of X. So E of X is given as 2. What is the variance of X? That is 4. So these are the two given values. So substituting 2 and 4 here, so variance of 4 is x, E of x square minus E of x is 2, 2 square. So what is 2 square becomes 4. When you take this minus 4 to the other side, 4 plus 4 is equal to E of x square. So what is c of x square value is 8. So here the option is D, that is 8. Question number 134. Mu 2 is equal to 20, mu 2 dash is equal to 276. For a discrete random variable x, then the mean of the random variable is option A 16, option B 5, option C 2, option D 1. So we know that variance formula is mu 2 equal to mu 2 dash minus mu 1 dash the whole square. So this is nothing but variance of x is equal to e of x square minus e of x the whole square. So here the variance is mu 2, that is 20, mu 2 dash is equal to 276 minus mu 1 dash the whole square. So when you take this mu 1 dash the whole square to the other side, mu 1 dash the whole square is equal to 276 minus 20, which gives you 256. When you take the square root on both sides, therefore mu 1 dash is equal to 16. So what is the option is? A is the correct option, that is 16. Question number 135. Variance of 4x plus 3 is option A 7, option B 16 variance of x, option C 19, option D 0. So variance of 4x plus 3 can be written as variance of 4x plus variance of 3. So what is variance of constant is 0. So here the variance of constant is 0. Variance of any constant is 0. So variance of AX is A square variance of x. So this is the formula to be remembered. So apply these two formula here. Variance of 4x is 4 square variance of x, whereas variance of 3 is 0 because 3 is a constant. Therefore 4 square is 16 variance of x. So what is the option is? B is the correct option, that is 16 variance of x. Question number 136. In 5 throws of a die, getting 1 or 2 is a success. The mean number of success is option A 5 by 3, option B 3 by 5, option C 5 by 9, option D 9 by 5. So number of trials is equal to 5, that is equal to n. The probability of getting 1 or 2 while throwing a die, so we are getting 2 events, so total number of possibility is 6. Therefore 2 by 6 is equal to 1 by 3, that is called as P, because it's a probability of the success P cases which is given in the problem. Therefore mean number of success is NP. So what is N is 5, P is 1 by 3, therefore what is the mean is 5 by 3. So hence the mean number of success is 5 by 3. So when you eliminate the option, we get A is the correct option, that is 5 by 3. Question number 137. The mean of a binomial distribution is 5 and its standard deviation is 2. Then the value of N and P is option A 4 by 5 comma 25, option B 25 comma 4 by 5, option C 1 by 5 comma 25, option D 25 comma 1 by 5. So the mean of a binomial distribution is given by the formula is NP. Therefore NP is equal to 5. So what about the standard deviation? The standard deviation is given by the formula root of NPQ, that is equal to 2. Therefore when you squaring on both sides, we get NPQ is equal to 4. So what is NP value is 5, because the mean is 5. Therefore 5Q is equal to 4. Therefore Q is equal to 4 by 5. Therefore the probability of the successful cases P is equal to 1 minus Q. Therefore P is equal to 1 minus 4 by 5. So that gives you 1 by 5. So what is the probability of the successful cases is P is equal to 1 by 5. Now we know that NP is equal to 5. Substituting P is equal to 1 by 5 here. Therefore N by 5 is equal to 5. Therefore N is equal to 25. So they are asking the value of N and P. Therefore D is the correct option, that is 25 comma 1 by 5 is the correct option. If the mean and standard deviation of a binomial distribution are 12 and 2 respectively, then the value of its parameter P is option A 1 by 2, option B 1 by 3, option C 2 by 3, option D 1 by 4. Here mean is equal to NP. So NP is given as 12, whereas the standard deviation is given by the formula root of NPQ, that is equal to 2. So these two values are given. Therefore when you square this value, we get NPQ is equal to 4. So what is NP value is 12. Therefore 12Q is equal to 4. therefore q is equal to 4 by 12, that is equal to 1 by 3. So in order to calculate p, you have to use the formula p is equal to 1 minus q. So what is q is 1 by 3. So what is 1 minus 1 by 3, that is 2 by 3. So what is the value of p is 2 by 3. So this is the parameter p, 2 by 3. Now look at the option, c is the correct option, that is 2 by 3. Number 139. In 16 throws of a die, getting an even number is considered as a success. Then the variance of the success is option A 4, option B 6, option C 2, option D 256. So in this problem, n is equal to 16 because it is the number of tries. So number of tries means n. So here n is equal to 16. So throwing a die, which implies that the sample space is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So there are 6 outcomes are there. So what's the product getting even number is? That is 2, 4 and 6. So there are 3 outcomes. Therefore 3 by 6, that is equal to 1 by 2. So that is nothing but P. This is considered as the probability of the success. Then what is the probability of failure cases? Q is equal to 1 minus P. So 1 minus 1 by 2 is equal to 1 by 2. Therefore Q is equal to 1 by 2. So what is the formula to find out the variance of the binomial distribution is? That is NPQ. So NPQ is the variance. Therefore here n is 16, P is 1 by 2, Q is 1 by 2. So 16 by 4 gives you 4. So what is the option is? A is the correct option, that is question number 140. A bag contains 6 red and 4 white balls. If 3 balls are drawn at random, the probability of getting 2 white ball is option A 1 by 20, option B 18 by 125, option C 4 by 25, option D 3 by 10. So there are 6 red balls and 4 white balls in a bag. Therefore the total number of bag is 10. So we are drawing 3 balls at a time. Therefore the total sample space is 10C3, that is equal to n of s. Therefore what is the sample space is 10C3. So that is equal to 120. So when you calculate 10C3, the value becomes 120. So the probability of getting 2 white and 1 red ball. So there are 4 white balls are there. Therefore there are possibilities 4C2. And out of 6 ball, there is 1 red ball. Since we have taken how many balls? 3 balls. Therefore 2 red balls and 1 white ball. Therefore 4C2 into 6C1 divided by 10C3. What is 10C3 value is? 120. What is 4C2 value is? 6. What is 6C1 value is? 6. 6 into 6 36. When you cancel with this, we get 3 by 10. Therefore what is the option is? D is the correct option. That is 3 by 141. If 2 cards are drawn from a well shuffled pack of 52 cards, the probability that they are the same color is option A 1 by 2, option B 26 by 51, option C 25 by 51, option D 25 by 102. So since 2 cards are drawn, the 2 card may be red and black. Both are red or both are black. Now I am finding the probability for both are red in color. So when you take the red cards, there are 26 red cards out of 52. Therefore the probability is 26 by 52. So when you take it one card, therefore the remaining is 25 by 51. Therefore it gives you 1 by 2 into 25 by 51. So when you cancel with 2, we will get 1 by 2 into 25 by 51. In a similar way, the probability of getting 2 black cards, that is 26 by 51 into 25 by 51, the same value, that is 1 by 2 into 25 by 51. Since they are of the same color, therefore you have to add the red probability as well as the black probability. So you take 1 by 2 as common factor, we will get 25 by 51 plus 25 by 51. That is equal to 1 by 2 into 25 plus 25 becomes 50 by 51. So when you cancel with 25, we will get 25 by 51. So what is option is? C is the correct option. That is 25 by 51. Question number 142. If in a Poisson distribution, P of capital X is equal to 0, equal to K, then the variance is option A, log 1 by K, option B, log K, option C, e power lambda, option D, 1 by K. So, what is the Poisson distribution? The Poisson distribution is given by the formula P of capital X is equal to small x implies e power minus lambda, lambda power x by factorial x. So, it is given that P of capital X is equal to 0. So, substituting x is equal to 0 here, that is equal to e power minus lambda, lambda power 0 by factorial 0. So, lambda power 0 is 1, factorial 0 is also equal to 1. Therefore, lambda power 0 by factorial 0, that is equal to 1. So, 1 into e power minus lambda is e power minus lambda. So, we can call it as equation number 1. And it is given that P of x is equal to 0, that is k, which is given. So, equation number 2. So, equating 1 and 2, we will get e power minus lambda is equal to k. Now, change into logarithmic form. So, this is an exponential form. You must change the exponential into logarithmic form. So, minus lambda is equal to log k to the base e. Therefore, lambda is equal to minus log k to the base e. So, here it is minus 1. So, we can raise the power, that is k power minus 1. K power minus 1 can be written as 1 by k. Therefore, what is lambda value is log of 1 by k to the base e. So, what is option is? A is the correct option, that is log 1 by k. Question number 143. If a random variable capital X follows Poisson distribution such that e of x square is equal to 30, then the variance of the distribution is option A 6, option B 5, option C 30, option D 25. So, in a Poisson distribution, which implies that mean and variance are equal. So, you can call it as mean is equal to lambda and variance is equal to lambda, because mean and variance are equal in the case of Poisson distribution. So, what is the variance formula is? Variance of x is equal to e of x square minus e of x the whole square. So, here variance is lambda, mean is also lambda. So, mean is nothing but what? E of x. Therefore, lambda square. So, lambda is equal to e of x square minus lambda square. So, what is e of x square value is given? That is 30. Therefore, lambda is equal to 30 minus lambda square. So, we can frame a quadratic equation, lambda square plus lambda minus 30 is equal to 0. When you factorize this, we get lambda plus 6 into lambda minus 5 is equal to 0. Therefore, lambda is equal to minus